观众朋友，大家好，欢迎来到本次的奥神金股小股票大收益，我是 Angel。今天很荣幸，我又找到了一家新的商业客户，他是来自 OTCQB 的，代码是 SZLSF，然后我请到他们的 CEO。Hello, James。
Hello, how are you?
I'm good. Thanks. It's my honor to have you to attend our today's interview, and please say hello to our audience.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us for this.
Okay, so the first thing I was looking for a statement, and I will escape the questions first because I want to, show the slide to the audience to introduce them what is Stage Zero doing and why I think this is a good undervalued stock. Okay, so let's start. 那在开始本次interview 之前，我会说一下免责声明。在本次的演示文稿当中，会有很多的预期、将类和这样类似的表达词语，一些识别性的、前瞻性的陈述，那也就反映了公司当前对未来事件的一些预期。这些前瞻性的陈述会有涉及风险跟不确定性，那希望大家能够理解。我准备了很多的问题啊，这些问题都是小钱让我来问的，非常非常的专业。那我们先跳过这些问题，先说一下我为什么会觉得 Stage Zero 是一个大家可以目前是个很好的机会吧，应该说。那么这是一个谈癌色变的时期，那目前的癌症是基本上能够查出来一半都已经是在晚期。那在 COVID 的19之后呢，癌症的筛查就少了很多。目前的癌症是出现在自费健康中排名第一的灾难性的一个健康索赔，国民经济为它买单是1508个亿美金，而且患癌症本身它会宣布破产的概率也比普通人大了2.5倍，所以预计今年大概是有190万的美国人，20万的加拿大人会被诊现出有癌症，然后目前全球是1810万的癌症病例。那这个癌症有多么恐怖，也就不需要我跟大家多说了。那怎么去更早的发现？那发现肯定是越早越好，所以早期的检测对挽救生命是有非常大的好处的。那下面的数据大家可以看到，早筛的话，那5年的生存几率和相比较晚发现的5年的生存几率是有一个天壤地之别的一个变化。我们现在给出了三大的一个方案啊，第一个是早期的筛查，第二个是发现之后的一个干预，最后是对于患者的一个新疗法。那早期的一个早筛，我们公司 Stage Zero 叫的名字也特别有意思啊，叫亚里士多德 （Aristotle）。那这是一个早期的癌症筛查，它是一个专有的一个 mRNA 的血液，就是单一的血液样本就可以测出多种的癌症，然后帮助我们发现癌症。发现之后，他会给出 avert 一个癌症的一个预防的干预的措施，然后给出一些积极的一些信号，对于早期癌症预备的一个警告信号，给出一个计划。最后就是 treat，能够帮助我们癌症的一些新疗法，针对癌症患者一些代谢，给出一些辅助的癌症疗法。那一个个说啊，先说亚里士多德这个，它是一个单一的，我一直在强调单一血液样本，它就可以提供挽救生命的干预措施，非常单一的血液，然后找出多种癌症的分子特征，及时发现癌症，可以显著改善患者预后时的一些治疗。那目前我们的亚里士多德可以检测出这9种癌症，并且我们的基础 mRNA 的技术哨兵原理是已经在9000多个患者当中得到验证，也已经被超过10万名的患者使用。然后我们看一下它的比较优势，跟之前目前已经市面上的一些别的癌症筛选的一些手段和方法去做一个优势，它的独特之处就在于它的高精度筛选早期癌症，这点非常重要。那么也是经过 CAP、CLIA 这些认证的高复杂性的一些实验室啊，确定啊，的确这东西很好。然后呢，就是来到我们的 avert 和 treat。Avert 就是识别可能导致癌症风险的一些因素，提供一些可操作性的一些信息，来帮助我们改变生活方式，降低风险。那 treat 它是一个个性个体化的一个治疗方案，通过针对不同的癌症来帮助降低癌症细胞总体的一个代谢率。那整个市场规模，大家不言而喻就能够想到，非常的大。2021年它的早筛市场是3220亿啊，去年是1720亿，那美国占比就占了45%啊，年复合增长率7%。 OK，那我们的市场目标也很清楚，是一些像雇主啊，会为员工提供福利，对吧？然后急救人员、保险公司、再保险公司一些预防性的健康的一些诊所。那我们先谈一下自筹资金雇主市场吧。自筹资金这些雇主呢，他会给员工去做一些保险，大概是涉及到1.57亿个人，64%的受保就业人员会享受自保、自我保险和自筹资金的一些安排。目前超过了1亿的美国人已经参加了自我的保险。那最大的自保群体很多是500及以上的一些大公司。那比如说，我们来个案例研究啊，治疗早期的乳腺癌，它成本通过我们这样子的一个早筛，就可以节省300多万美元。然后它在自筹资金雇主市场的渗透率啊，我们认为是可以辐射到1亿人的。那比如说我们有1万个员工，那大概营收是1280万。那如果是10万个员工，那就1.28亿的营收。那盈利模式呢？现在已经是建立一些合作伙伴，比如说急救人员，北美就有390个，专注是在美国、加拿大、安大略省，因为我们这家公司来自于加拿大的多伦多。那安大略省的消防员全职的是11.1万名，兼职的是19,000名。那包括一些 Health Today 之类的诊所啊、政府啊建立的，或者是政府早期的一些癌症的测试点项目和一些实验室的合作伙伴，目前是覆盖50个州，实验室遍布整个美国，然后扩大了很多的业务啊，以及一些主要的癌症中心，像英国、加拿大、美国的临床研究中心等等。以及我们的收入来源啊，我们做一次亚里士多德的癌症早筛是949美金，那代谢小组也会有些咨询费啊，然后每季度的是795。那预计大概25%的员工会采用一些风险因子的修正的计划，并且坚持可能会3到4个季度一直来咨询。那大概这个收入是1590到2385美金之间。那我们到下一阶段就是 treat 怎么去帮你去治疗，这个临床项目是2495美元。那这个我们要说的是，很多测试它是一次性计费的，那临床的项目就是一些经常性的定期的现金流收入。最后呢，可以看一下我们的团队啊，目前是有40多名员工，4个董事会成员和一个科学的顾问委员会。那董事会成员呢，包括我们今天请来的 CEO James，以及我们另外的3位，还有我们的科学顾问。啊，这就是我们的 Stage Zero 整体的一个情况。那我再来复述一遍，它是一家在 OTC 科币挂牌，它的代码是 SCLSF，处于癌症早筛这个技术前沿的一个创新早期检测，降低成本，人人受益。好，我们现在来问小千，看了这家公司之后非常感兴趣，让我一定要问的问题啊，一共是6个，非常非常专业，也希望能够帮助我们的观众朋友们更好的了解这家 Stage Zero 它有哪些优势啊？它现在的股价非常的低，大家可以去看一下，甚至可以考虑说是不是在低位就可以吸入，那么可以一起伴随着这样的公司一起来成长。OK，Jen，thank you for waiting me. I have briefly introduced what is Stage Zero doing, and let's talk the ask you questions about the whole company. It seems like your company. It seems like your company realized early diagnosis through mRNA. Well, there are also technologies such as ctDNA, ctc. So, what are the mRNA technology pros and cons?
Certainly. We're one of the pioneers of liquid biopsy. So we were one of the very first groups to actually start with mRNA gene expression. So advantage through all of this is the technology's been in place for about 20 years. It's been extremely well accepted for about 10 years. So solid, proven, lots of work around it. I think the thing with ctDNA and CTCs, although they're very promising, it's still fairly early in the science. And so we're watching this, it's sort of an improving technology. And if you think about it, everyone started looking for circulating tumor cell DNA. That didn't work too well, so they added methylation. We now seem to be focused mostly on methylation. So I think everyone's still sorting out where it goes. I think the two main advantages that we have, or the mRNA gene expression technology has over, ctDNA and CTCs, is really that mRNA finds all stages of cancer equally well. So we find early cancer, stage one and stage two, equally as well as three and four. In actual fact, in the sort of new form of the colorectal cancer that we're developing, we're going to separate it even into polyps. So we'll go even earlier than that. Circulating tumor cells don't do this. And it's fairly obvious why not. They seem to have their ability mostly to find late stage cancers. And I've heard it described as following, which is to find circulating tumor cells of even large cancers. It's like finding a needle in a haystack. To find it off of very small, tiny tumors, it's like finding a needle in 100 haystacks. And so it makes lots of sense. And I think if we look at the very large study that's ongoing in the UK right now, we'll see that they're focused very heavily on symptomatic patients. So in other words, it's not asymptomatic, it's not all comers, it's symptomatic patients. So people that are presumed to have cancer. And then even there, although they're getting a respectable 73% of the cancers, these are in people that are presumed to have cancer. Now, when you move it out to all comers, and then when you move it out to early cancer, in actual fact, your results drop off very markedly. So we would say one of the key differentiators, in fact, probably the number one key differentiator, is that we find early cancer as well as late. The other technologies seem to find mostly late. The second piece in this is that we report on individual cancers. So if we're screening for breast cancer or colorectal or bladder, first of all of our controls are all people. So as we've talked about, those without cancer as well as with cancer, but we also do a lot of other diseases. So therefore we can control for all of that. So when we come to tell you that, for example, you may have colorectal cancer, we specifically mean colorectal cancer. ctDNA and CTC typically rank order their findings. And so they'll say, well, we believe it is breast, but if it's not breast, then it's colorectal. And if it's not colorectal, then it's bladder. And so it's more of a search to find out exactly what it is. And of course, physicians don't really like that. They really want to be able to go directly into the cancer. So I would say that's our second key differentiator.
Got it. Thank you. 我刚才问他，我说你们是通过 mRNA 实现早期的技术，那同时其实还有 ctDNA 跟 CTC 技术，那您认为 mRNA 的技术的优点跟缺点是什么？那他已经说了，就 mRNA 这块技术它定义非常明确的，已经是有20年了，那被接受已经是10多年，那 ctDNA 跟 CTC 是在开发中，尚未得到充分的验证。 mRNA 呢是可以很好的发现癌症的所有阶段，一二三四阶段都能，那比如说在结肠癌当中， mRNA 是可以让我们区分到息肉还是癌症病变，那以便能够非常进行非常早期的筛查，不依赖一些甲基化的标记。那 ctDNA 跟 CTC 可能是能够筛选到一些晚期的癌症嘛，那 ctDNA 跟 CTC 在大量肿瘤中就很难找到，而且在早期的小肿瘤中也是比较难找到的，甲基化会随着肿瘤的成熟而增加，因此呢我们早期癌症就很难找到，因此他就觉得该技术对早期癌症能力会比较差也就是说他认为 mRNA 也就是我们现在用的技术会更成熟更有效一些。那第二个区别呢，就是 mRNA 是允许对个体癌症进行一个离散性的筛查，帮助我们检测一些像乳腺癌啊、膀胱癌、结肠癌等等，那对照的就是没有癌症的患者。那换句话说比如说我们认为您有癌症，那就是有癌症，我说你有结肠癌的风险，那就是有结肠癌。而相反呢，我们的 ctDNA 和 CTC 它的样本进行排序，它不是离散的，所以他说你可能是乳腺癌，如果不是乳腺癌可能是结肠癌，如果不是结肠癌可能是什么别的癌这就是两个技术之间的一个关系性的区别。Thank you. So the second question, who are the main players in mRNA segment and your company's strengths and weakness?
Yes, we're essentially the primary player in the space. mRNA gene expression technology is used in all kinds of ways in terms of where it is. But no one else at this juncture has developed a multi-cancer diagnostic. So we're fortunate enough in that we stand alone in that. Aristotle, as we started it, in actual fact, was whole body. So, but we lacked the billions of dollars that would enable us to develop it that way. So we started in a number of diseases, focused down into cancer. And so I think that's what's given us the advantage in all of this. Our strength is that we're well known. The strength is, as I say, we're one of the pioneers. We have over 20 years worth of experience in working with this, and that the technology is terribly well known. What your weakness, I would say, is that clearly we're still relatively small. We need ongoing support in order to truly commercialize this. But I think I would also say we believe that we have the opportunity to reach the break-even point with our company by year end, which is quite remarkable for a group like this. And we've got a lot of the key players in place in order from a partnering perspective. So we're actually looking forward to the next 6 months being really, really strong for us.
Got it. Thank you. 我又问他 mRNA 领域主要参与者有哪些，然后您认为您公司的优势和劣势。那其实是在 mRNA 这个基因表达技术商业公司里面，可以说我们 stage zero 就仅此一家，所以他也没有什么主要的一些参与者。那如果说他们公司的优势，他们已经花了非常多的钱在这上面，已经20年了，一直孜孜不倦在，而且他们选择癌症筛选这个技术，用 mRNA 去做癌症找筛。优势的话就是非常久啊，这技术也非常成熟，然后也一直在致力于研究。那如果说劣势的话，这家公司目前是一家比较小的公司，他们也在寻求更多的合作伙伴。那他非常期待就是未来6个月他们会跟更多的一些很强劲的一些实验室啊、医院啊等等，包括一些别的商业合作伙伴一起把这个公司给做起来，这也是为什么他想来跟我们中文投资网的观众呢来了解更多，希望大家能够关注他的原因。So the third question, what cancer are more suitable for using a product?
Well, that's a good question. Actually, we appear to be able to do all cancers. So whether they solid tumors or blood, in fact, crossing blood-brain barrier, for example, glioblastoma. And, for example, there is currently no screening test for glioblastoma. When you typically find it, it's very late and it's devastating. So being able to find it would be key. So that is where we're going. We currently do 10 different cancers. We're building out to essentially 15. Now, yes, this includes subtypes within the various as well. But we're trying to make sure that we stay within the realm of what is standard of care. We don't want to go into the esoteric cancers because that then gets difficult to chase down. So this is by essentially medical demand in terms of where we focus. But just to pull back again, we do all kinds of other diseases as well. So there seems to be relatively little limit to what the technology can do.
Thank you. 我又问他，我说那么你这个癌症找下是每个癌症都可以吗？还是说有一些更适合你用你的？他说其实可以查出所有形式的癌症。那目前他们测试的大概是10种不同的癌症样本，并且另外还有5个别的癌症疾病的样本，那应该说是15个。那其实所有的癌症都可以去筛，然后也会去尝试做一些非识别性的癌症，比如说克罗恩病啊，或者是什么间歇一些不明原因的一些肠道的一些炎症啊，或者是什么心理衰竭之类的，这些都可以。如果回到哪些癌症适合，所有的癌症都适合。OK, the fourth question. What are your products sensitivity specificity, PPV and NPV? It's very terminology.
Yes, no, you did that very well. Those are not easy. It's also a difficult one at times to understand, and particularly when you're working within a multi-cancer diagnostic. So the way to do it is to actually go to some of the published papers and to look at each individual cancer. But I'll give you the overall piece. Today, most focus is on trying to make sure that you have as few false positives as possible. So therefore, people set the specificity as high as they can. We've typically chosen 99%, so most of our cancers are set at that level. We've got two set at 95% because it provides a better balance. But so specificity, 99% in general. Sensitivity ranges from 85% to essentially 100%, so 99.9%. Again, varies across the different cancers. The majority, I think 9 of the 10 cancers are in the low to high 90s in terms of where. So by and large, overall, we have industry-leading statistics. NPV, it is interesting because that's where people seem to be putting a lot of focus these days. So NPV really is, you know, what is your false positive rate? And we typically, we have an NPV of 99%. So it's very high. It's a little surprising because it used to be do not miss a cancer. Now it is, we'll rather miss one or two cancers, but report as few false positives as you can. Mm. And so that ties back to your specificity, ties back to your NPV. PPV is a more difficult one. And because PPV is tied to each individual cancer, it's tied to the point prevalence of the disease. The only way to actually truly talk about them is you've got to take it cancer by cancer. You've got to look at the comparatives in the marketplace and then go in certain of the diseases where you have relatively low point prevalence. So that's what cancer does generally have. The best you can ever achieve on a PPV is in fact 50%. So the best way to answer again would be to have people refer back to the papers. But I can tell you that we have industry leading PPVs across all of this. So the test is certainly more accurate than the vast majority of what is out there. And it's as good as or better than pretty much the rest.
Understood. Thank you. 这个问题是小钱问的，他这个大家应该知道，小钱他非常擅长这些医疗方面的。他让我问产品的 A 灵敏度，特 B 特异性 ，C 阳性预测值和 D 阴性预测值。那为了更好的让大家理解什么是什么阳性预测值、阴性预测值，包括什么 CC PPV 跟 PV 啊，我截了这个图。那正阳性在这里啊，然后假阳性在这里。这里就是患者患癌的和未患癌的，所以它分患癌的测试的阳性跟未患癌的测试的阴性啊，这些大家可以去看。所以它的灵敏度呢就是这么一个公式，大家可以看一下。然后特异性是这么一个公式，阳性的预测值是正阳性人群去除以这一个公式，以及阴性预测值是这么一个公式。那回到刚才的问题，他们是跨越十种癌症，它的特异性大概是 99% 是相当高的，然后其中两个是 95%， 然后灵敏度是85-99%之间，也是非常高的。 NPV 基本上是99，是一个非常好的数据。 PPV 呢就是要看癌症的患病率而已，因为要每次单独检测不同的癌症啊，所以这一块我是特地拿出来问，是因为这个数据能够更好的反映这个公司的实力啊。到底因为你做癌症筛选最重要的是准不准，就很简单嘛，因为我们普通人的话就是准不准，有多准啊，就这么一个问题。 OK， 好，第五个问题。 So the fifth question, what is insurance coverage of a product?
Yes, we're actually too early for insurance coverage, so we haven't applied yet. In actual fact, none of the multi-cancer diagnostics, and there are in fact just two of us out there at the moment, neither of us have applied. It's going to take a significant amount of time. You typically have to go through FDA, from FDA to USPSTF, and take through. So we're all working in the private payer market. You'll see it for us, that works extremely well.Patients these days, in terms of where insurance has gone, mostly pay for a lot of this themselves. But additionally, that's why the focus on, for example, employers, insurance companies, all of this, that works extremely well.
Understood. 我有问他你们产品的保险范围是多少比例的能够报，他说其实这个申报保险还是很长的一个漫长过程，所以他们现在目前呢，是专注于个人的一个付费啊自费的一个阶段，也像包括前面我有在过那个 PPT 的时候，大家也有看到，就是很多的雇主啊会为我们的雇员去做一些自筹性自费的一些保险呢，是这块是我们目前的。阶段啊，主要是私人付费这块。So the last question, what is your sales expectation in the next 3 to 5 years?
Yes, that's always a difficult one. How do you reach out that way? I think the way that we've answered it is certainly $500 million plus. I think if we achieved less than $500 million in that time frame, we'd be very disappointed. Obviously, the upside is significantly larger than that. They're extremely large markets as you drive through. And part of the presentation, as you saw, is we laid out how quickly revenue builds. If we got 100,000 patients into this or 100,000 employees, it's over 100 million, it's 112 million, I think, in terms of what revenue is. When you look at 100 million, employees out there within the self-funded space, 100,000 is not that many. So, you know, it's from there through to, everyone else that we're working with, the lab groups, the clinics, and so on. And so it expands very rapidly. So, as I said, difficult to give precise estimates, but certainly we would expect not less than that.
Understood, thank you. 我问他未来三五年销售预期，他这是最难回答的一个问题啊。那他认为是$5亿。那刚才我其实也有给到一个数据的来源，我是为什么觉得他可以拿到，他自认为可以做到$5亿啊。看一下，应该是在这张，对，这张图大家可以看一下，每一次收入就是你做一次癌症筛查，包括后面那些咨询是费用是多少。然后目前他想涉足的人员是多少，那是这张图啊，比如说他能够渗透到10,000个员工的公司，那就是1280万的营收，那100,000个员工公司就1.28亿了，对，所以他认为$5亿应该还是一个比较可以达到的，因为只要跟现在已经在跟很多的自付保险的一些雇主再去谈，包括一些别的一些实验室啊等等。好，这就是我今天找到的一家公司，是在 OTCQB 的，其实它也在多伦多交易所有挂牌，如果您是加拿大有多伦多证券那个开户的也可以关注一下，在多伦多它是 SELS， 在我们美国 OTCQB 是 SELSF。是做一个癌症筛查前沿的公司啊，它可以大大降低成本，人人都可以受益。非常感谢我们的 James， 也非常感谢观众朋友们来收看本次的奥神金谷哦。我希望之后能够为大家更多的带来像这家 Stage Zero 这样公司的一些更多的信息，也欢迎大家关注我们的微信公众号，来到我们的官网 ChineseFN.com 去看更多相关的一些信息和邮件。Okay, that's all. Thank you so much, James. I appreciate you attend our interview, and I will ask our audience to follow up the company, Stage Zero. Okay.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.